one equation. Let's start as usual with an example. The problem that we will focus today is this one. Do you see equation subcondition? First, I like you to touch some analysis. Do you recognize some familiar picture? And together some difference between this problem and the last heat problem. Let's start with equation. Do you see a difference or the similarity between this equation and the y and the heat equation? Equation first. Okay, you still have derivative respectively and derivative respect as respect as still second order, but respectively instead of first order you have second order. Understand equation different. Later we will say this is y equation. But how about the boundary condition? Okay, this is same. So you get because condition for S similarly. So here we will have which kind of solution? Sin of cos. Okay, we get that maybe this is sin. And the last this is initial condition, but here we have two. So now let's solve. I will remix some picture of variable. The first step still done. We touch u s t equal s s t t. When we substitute, we touch the second derivative respect t. So this will be 2 t2 prime multiply s equal 4 times. What about the second derivative respect s here still done? This will be s2 prime multiply t. So as usual, we bring s to one hand side. So you divide s there. And t to other hand side. And because we will start, we guess for s. So we touch the left hand side with s. As simple as possible. That's why we leave number 4 for right hand side. And now you know left hand side is bet s, right hand side is bet t, and they are always equal. So both of them must be lambda. Understand? So you continue to use boundary condition and we look for non-trivial solution. So you will have S2 prime minus lambda S equal 0, S0 equal S by S0, and together T2 prime minus for lambda t equals 0. First step finished. But I hope that you recognize something here. Even the equation changed. But now how about the problem for the S? Do you have the new problem for S? So you must say this one absolutely similar, the same problem. When we treat heat division, understand? So immediately, because we already study heat problem, you say if you look for non-trivial solution, so lambda must be minus n square, understand? And the basic solution is CNS, which satisfy that condition, S0 is back to zero. Now, return for T, if lambda equal minus n square, you will have T plus 4 n square T equal zero. I hope that you see this equation. This we already studied, T2 prime plus 4 n square T equal zero. You must consider 4 n square like constant. So that's why I hope I need one work. If you can tell me this work, I completely agree that you understand, you remember the first time. Which magical work that's the most suitable for this equation? Homogeneous, exactly. This is the second order linear homogeneous with coefficient constant. So student, so if this is homogeneous, so by that you will write k square plus 4 n square, this is zero. So k this a plus minus 2 and 9. So you have t now for each n will be Cn cos 2n t plus dn sin 2n t. Understand? And so because we look for u, you must say s multiply t. And now we are in the same situation with this problem. We found basic solution, but there we have not only one basic solution. In fact, how many basic solutions we have here? For any natural number and a greater than one. So totally we have infinitely basic solutions. So what you must do with them? Like any homogeneous linear equation, you will get the sum. But because here we have infinitely term, so instead of normal sum, you will say another magical word. Describe solution in heat in white. The problem we study here, which work I need for you, where you have infinitely terms, you must touch the sum, but because this is infinitely, so this not usual sum, which work I wait for you. Series one more time, still done. Now, finally, you have you with me?
student.
Immediately, now we will use the initial condition. But I like you to remember that formula. And student, I like you to immediately tell me the more general formula if we now realize that problem. For example, student, if instead of 0 to pi, but you have 0 to L, so what you must do inside that formula? Substitute rightly and by and by over L. Next, what happens, student? In the y equation, instead of number 4, I touch for example number 9. Okay, just start with the same S from 0 to pi. So number 9 here will appear where? Okay, you will say instead of 4 you have 9. So there will be 9. So this is 3. So you will have the kind of IA cos 3 and T, B and C 3 and T. Understand? But outside the same C and S. Did you hear me? Okay, now we continue with initial condition. So student, I repeat the solution, the sum of AN cos 2nt plus bn sin 2nt sin ns. Understand? Now, let's treat first condition. When you cut t equals 0, what happens inside the series? You will have sin 0 this a, 0 cos 0 this a, 1. So you will have the sum of an sin ns equal 3 sin n minus 5 sin 5s. Immediately, I must say, some students can see something wrong here. Teacher, I remember that last time you talked, we will use AN for cos. Why did we have AN for sin? In fact, student, distinguish. Last time when we talked AN for cos, this is a Fourier series with cos initially. Here, I must say, this is the Fourier, but CN is still there, and the coefficient, this is dark bracket, A and B and together. Understand? So, when that one becomes A and we are safe. I like to highlight that, because student, today, when I write that bracket with T, I write A and cos, B and sin. But tomorrow, maybe I will write AN sin 2NT plus BN cos 2NT. Do you understand? Because sin 2NT and cos 2NT, they are similar. So the fact that I write AN here, BN there, and tomorrow I change, it must be the same. Don't remember, don't learn by heart from là try to remember only when you substitute equal zero, one will cancel, another will remain, and you have the usual problem for CNNS. Do you understand? So here, nothing to surprise, we get I want this A, 3, and next with I still done, A4 minus 5, and another AN is 0. But now, listen, a next tricky detail still done. Here, you have two initial condition, understand? The first one we use for AN. So soon you will guess the second one we must use for BN. And so some of you can write very fast answer. Okay, teacher, we go that's one for BN. So when N equal 3, I guess B3 equal 2. And I must say immediately this is wrong. So now why this wrong? Still done. See here, we don't substitute. Usually we take derivative first and we substitute. Now I will say one very fast discussion. Spend attention to Kashi. When you take derivative, respective cos will become minus c. But when you substitute t equals 0, sin 0 is a 0, so that one cancel. In fact, you can guess, and you guess rightly. You find already an. So for second condition, you need no spend attention to an. Only for bn. So when you take derivative, sin 2nt becomes not only cos but outside 2n to be outside. So you will have the sum still done. 2n outside, understand? Multiply bn, sin becomes cos, substitute t equals 0, cos will be 1. And that one will cancel. So now you have the same problem bn there, but 2n outside more. Multiply sin n s equal 2 sin 3s. So finally we get n equal 3, but for n equal 3, you have here sin b3 equal 2, not only b3, so b3 equal 1 over 3. And now finally you have the full answer. What is full answer? When n equal 1, you have a 1, this is 3. N equal 1, so you have cos 2t sin n. Next, n equal 3, b3, so you have 1 over 3. N equal 3, sin 6t sin 3s. And the last, a4, n equal 4, so a4 equal minus 5. N equal 4, you have cos 8t sin 4s. Understand? Terrible solution. You must find A and B and together. But I believe the way to find A clear. Clear in the meaning still done. When you substitute T equals 0, you find A and. Next, you will forget A and. Take derivative, the remaining bn will appear. Don't forget additional factor. Do you understand? Do you understand? We will have the similar problem when you substitute that number for that by there. But now I think, let's jump directly to the general problem. So student, why we have to study that problem? In fact, this problem appears when, for example, you like guitar. Guitar, you have string, understand? Initially, do you hear any sound from your guitar? No. But when you touch one part, the guitar string in motion. And when you have the vertical depression, that we know USD, you hear the sound. And we can show that this depression USD satisfy Y equation. Understand? Next, can you hear the sound? Can you play guitar if your guitar string is not fixed at the end? No. So you need the condition U equals zero. And still done. Listen carefully. When we study this problem, we study the name and condition because you have physical meaning. But for Y equation, like guitar string, understand? If you don't fix to end, we never have the organization. We never have the sound. So in Y equation, we have only one kind of orientation. This is Dirichlet. That's mean here, you have on Y, sin and S. Don't worry for cos and S. Don't worry. Okay. And because you have A and B and, so you have two initial conditions. This is the first boundary, Dirichlet. That's the string outside of balance, understand? And as so fast. Okay? And I think now we can write directly the general formula. Stand attention, you need A square there. So what will be your final solution here, student? USD equal, I will write one very big sum there. So what we have inside, student? AN multiply cos. Remember we last problem we have 4, so we got 2. If we have 9, so we got 3. So surely if we have A square, we have A multiply N pi over LT. Understand? Root plus BN multiply the same machine. And on multiply, excuse me, because we have Dirichlet condition respect S, so here you have only sin solution, sin N pi over LS. If you substitute T equals zero, student, so you will have the first one sin T equals zero. So you have the sum AN sin over equal FS S from 0 to L. So you get AN this A 2 over L integral of FS sin N by S over L. Next, when you touch the derivative respectively, so now I repeat my discussion, student. If you want, you can touch the derivative, but it's very long. I scare that you spend more your effort. You can even make mistakes. So remember, when you touch derivative, and you found, so you forget. Understand? That one will cancel, BN. But the additional term inside student will be outside. So you have the sum BN multiply A N pi over L. Do you see the factor inside multiply sin N pi S over L equal G S. So now the same student, you have B N equal that one you divide. So L over A N pi multiply 2 over L integral of G S multiply the same sin. That's it. So the only thing I worry when you use the second condition, when you touch derivative, don't forget the superfactor. Understand? And the last notation, student, we have two special cases that can reduce your computational work. What happens, student, if you have Fs equals 0? So when F equals 0, here on An will 0. Understand? Similarly, when Gs equals 0, you will have Bn, this is 0. So student, generally, in your entropy, you can have four small questions for us. The first one, you have 0 byte and simple initial condition. You need not put it wrong. The second, n equals 0, you find only 1. The next, g equals 0, you find only 1. Understand? And the last, both f, g different from 0. And you must involve Fourier integral. Okay? So, I think now you understand the rule. So let's do the last example. I write what is the problem here. Student, UTT equal to USS S from 0 to 3. US 0, excuse me, I write wrong order. S must be first, so here U 0T and U 3T is 0. US 0 equal for this symbol square root of S. Derivative respect T equal exponential minus S. Understand? I ask you approximate 1/5 by the first term. The first term. So now let's do together with me. What do we do firstly, student? Okay, here I first write the zero answer, rightly. UST equal the sum A and God, God which one? So, okay, exactly. Distinguish well with the he understand he is a square, so square root two and pi over three t understand plus b n sin square root two and pi over three t multiply sin and pi s over three exactly. T equals 0, you will have the sum an sin but here we stop. Teacher, we ask us to find by the first term. The first term, so we touch code or sin. Students, spend attention. That question we don't raise last week because last week you did only the series inside your new one term. But here, in fact, what I mean when I say the first term. Student in the series, the most important this is N. N, this is the order of the series. So I when I say the first term, I mean N equal 1. When N equal 1, you have both code and sin. So we don't have a right of taking only code or only sin. They are the same. Understand? So when you have such series, when I mean the first term, you must set and the equal one, you must find both A1 and B1. Do you understand? So please remember that. And this day, naturally, in the series, when I mean the first and second, only N will decide. Do you understand? You cannot say teacher because I write C first, so I will touch B1. No, no, no. No, good and sin same. So here you have A1. This is 2 over 3 integral 0 to 3 of that one multiply sin by S over 3. One more time, you stop into I. And after that, touch the derivative T equals 0. You have B n, and which one you will assign? Okay, this factor square root 2 and pi over 3, the same sin n pi n over 3. So you have B 1. Okay, don't forget divide that. So you have 3 over square root 2 over 3 multiply 2 over 3 integral of exponential minus s sin by s over 3 and you solve into B. And your final answer, student, now on your calculator. Ladies book, A and this is A. Cos square root 2 pi over 3 y because you don't have t, so you will use y is equal to t square root 2 pi y over 3 plus b sin square root 2 pi over 3 y multiply sin by s over 3 and you use CILC. S equal 1, y equal 0.5. Do you understand? You will use y is equal to t. Okay, it's naturally. please fix that problem or practice with question.